Hello guys, this is Vysh and this is a new initiative from us. This will be called the Vysh News Updates and this will be episode 1. So the topic today is after black fungus, now white fungus is reported in India. So we'll see what is the news and what is black fungus, because that has been news since last few weeks. So I'll give you entire details which can be technically related to your exam point of view. And because this can be useful for other competitive exams also, this kind of news updates which we do will be put in Vysh Courses channel. So please subscribe to Vysh IAS and Vysh Courses, both the channels, because we are trying to keep entire thing free. So if you don't subscribe and support us, we'll have to move these to again paid portals like other institutions are doing. So please see to it that you subscribe us. As per your request, we have taken up the initiative of taking the contemporary issues and discussing with you here free of cost. So please see to it that you take our request of subscribing to the channel. So this has been in news in almost every region, every regional news channels, this is being there. So that is why we thought we'll discuss this and give you some insights into it. So the news is 4 cases of white fungus infection, which is considered more dangerous than black fungus, has been reported from Patna, Bihar. One of the infected patients is a famous doctor from Patna. So white fungus infection is more dangerous than black fungus infection because it affects not only the lungs, okay, it affects other body parts as well, including nails, skin, stomach, kidney, brain, private parts and mouth. However, as a matter of big relief, all the 4 patients were cured by antifungal medicines. So there is a hope that this will not spread too much, and even if somebody is getting affected, it will be cured. White fungal infection attacks people with weak immunity, same like the black fungus. Diabetes patients or those who are taking steroids for a long time are most likely to get infected by white fungus. Now this black fungus we'll discuss a little bit, because white fungus, the news has just come today. So because it's similar to black fungus, we'll see what is the detailing of black fungus. So mucormycosis, also known as black fungus or zygomycosis, is caused by a group of mold called mucormycetes. So these fungi, where it exists, it lives in the environment, particularly in soil and in decaying organic matter such as leaves, compost piles or rotten wood, according to the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. The black fungus grows in the condensation lines and drip pans of air conditioners. In short, it has always been everywhere around us. People catch mucormycosis by coming in contact with the fungal spores in the environment. It can also develop on the skin after the fungus enters the skin through a cut, scrape, burn or other types of skin trauma. Union Health Ministry urged the state governments to make black fungus a notifiable disease under the Epidemics Disease Act 1897. So this becomes important for you. So notifiable disease means this has to be now mandatorily reported by everyone to the center. Okay, everybody has to comply to the norms. They have to see that they have the arrangements to deal with such cases when it comes. And they have to give the exact statistics to the center. Okay. This can be very dangerous if left untreated. The symptoms are headache, facial pain, nasal congestion, loss of vision or pain in the eyes, swelling in cheeks and eyes, black crust in the nose, coughing, bloody vomits, altered mental status. The treatment available is an antifungal intravenous injection, which cost around ₹3,500 a dose, and has to be administered every day for up to 8 weeks, is the only drug effective against this disease. The Drug Control General of India in March this year approved Mumbai-based biopharmaceutical firm Bharat Serums and Vaccine Limited to use antifungal medication, which is named like this, okay, LAMB in short, liposomal amphotericin, as a medical intervention in patients of mucormycosis. But there is a catch to it. So we'll see a little more details. It is on extremely rare occasions that it should affect people whose immune system is compromised, like uncontrollable diabetes patients or steroid or cancer patients on chemotherapy. In the last 10 years, if you see the fact, only handful of patients have reported this in India. But last week, all of a sudden, thousands of cases of black fungus have been reported in patients suffering or recovering from COVID-19. So there should be some reason, right? In fact, if you check, millions of patients in India suffering from diabetes or steroid or cancer patients are admitted to hospital in India every year, but nobody gets this infection. Even in the world, across the world, many are getting COVID and are diabetic. They are put on steroids. Their immune system is compromised, but they also don't report black fungus. Then why is there a sudden surge of mucormycosis among COVID patients in India only? That is what we have to see. So basically there are few reasons, okay, 3 mistakes actually, that I'll show you what are the 3 mistakes and we'll conclude this video. So the main cause is, the root cause is the completely unhygienic and dirty way of delivering oxygen to patients in many places in India, combined with the indiscriminate use of steroids in the treatment of COVID-19. So oxygen supply and steroids, that is where the problem is. So we'll see the three mistakes. The first mistake is related to oxygen. Medical oxygen, which we'll be seeing in news, as opposed to industrial oxygen, it is a highly purified version that is more than 99.5% pure by preparing it through repeated step of compression, filtration and purification. The cylinders in which the liquid oxygen is stored, transported and used are rigorously cleaned and disinfected. Oxygen, especially when administered to patients at high flow, requires humidification. This is done by passing it through a container filled with sterile water. The water itself must be sterilized and changed frequently as per protocol. If the water is not sterilized, it will be a potential source of black fungus infection, especially if high oxygen flow is given over a long period. So, if oxygen is given without humidification, it will dry the mucous membrane and damage the inner lining of the lungs. It will also make the sputum or secretion very thick to clear out. Both of these have created havoc among patients. So, the oxygen supply, okay, the cleanliness and humidification. This is the first mistake being done because of which black fungus disease is getting spread. Now, the second mistake is the use of steroids in the treatment of COVID-19. Okay, at the right time. You have to give it at the right time. Steroids, if you know, they are only effective to fight the effects of COVID, not the virus directly. Okay, it can fight the effect, not the virus. It is dangerous and harmful if given early when the virus is replicating. This will reduce body immunity and facilitate further replication of viruses. So there is a proper timing to be done, but that's not being followed. Giving steroids unnecessarily or early to a diabetic patient will raise their sugar level to a high level, predisposing them to further risk of increase in severity of COVID, as well as predisposing them to the ill effect of black fungus. So this is the second mistake. Okay, the timing of steroids. Now the third mistake, while it is good initiative to ramp up the production of medicine, which we discussed in the previous slide, to treat black fungus, we must understand that this disease kills 46 to 96% of people once infected. However, the bitter truth is that this medicine is very toxic also. So you just cannot increase the production of this and keep giving to patients. Okay, once you get this disease, anyway, these many people are going to die. So you have to correct your earlier two mistakes. The real solution is to enforce quality control and compliance for production, storage in cylinder, delivery, sterile water, clean system oxygen, as well as stop indiscriminate use of steroids to minimize the new enemy. So these are the things which is there across newspapers. We have compiled it for you. So hope you like this session. If you liked it, please see to it that you subscribe, because without your support, we'll not be able to keep this free content alive. So I'll come up with the next episode of this Vysh News Updates. Thank you and have a nice day.